Is there one of those towers falling again? Blocks until like party. They had like a jumping puzzle last year. Oh come on, interrupted my ass.
Ooh.
Is that what we needed to survive?
Yeah.
My guys are good.
I mean, he's literally just cut off the pennies.
Anchor of Lucha. I could.
He's on call.
We don't usually have a problem with it.
Yeah,
that's
I was going to say, we have a problem there.
Cool.
But to humor Anthony, I'll provision it somehow.
No, just leave it wherever it's been.
Well, there'll be plenty of time for it to cool down before I need it. Blocks into life parties.
I
its eyes into partners. Purple safe. Locks into life party, whoever it's max melee. Sides, max melee. Sides, max melee.
Stay close.
Yep, do not move.
Is that the tank or?
The tank didn't have to move either, but it. Everyone together for sticks. Check whether your orb, your AoE spawns, or your position on its opposite. Clocks into partners. Circle and get you. Tether in, everyone out.
The partner.
The partner, yep. No! Good pull.
But yes, when the AoE spawn, they have a little pink line that will come out of them showing which direction they go. You want to start on the opposite side of that pink line. And if they happen to spawn north and south, remember, Light Party 2 is checked looking at the northern orb, and Light Party 1 is looking at the southern.
Just rotate.
He's not in chat.
Cast it. I'm not reading.
Would he get his ass on here?
Melee light parties. Party spots, check ads. Partners. walks into a life party. Knockers into partners. Spots. Check ads. Partners. Waters. Check out Alpha. Clocks into partners.
Goodbye, Haru.
Chose
someone else.
Did you jump the gun there?
No, I just didn't have a partner.
No, I mean, with me and Khan, he was supposed to be my partner right there.
No, you probably saved Haru.
White safe. Box into partners.
Oh. No. Oh,
sides into partners.
They I'm not focused on DPS mechanic during that part really. I'm trying to slide caster and
just wipe.
Hey, I leave.
Not for long.
That was too much of a clusterfuck run.
Damn, only 5th in healing.
I'll try.
Gotta use bloodbath more. Was I like 3rd?
I didn't pay attention.
Probably one of the times. Into partners.
Light party.
Fox into light party. Bravo. sides into partners. White safe. Clocks until my parties. Render its max related distance. Sides max melee, sides max melee. Hold, don't move.
Will you be judged worthy to exist?
Add party spots. And watch where your AoE spawns. Check positions. Cycle. Careful in the middle. Remember, we're running to true north clock spots after this. True north clock spots. It's gonna be clocks into partners. Clocks into partners. Good job.
Oh.
Tether in, everyone out. Then partners. It's time for letter of law. Everybody is going to position on the east side while the tanks will be waiting on the around the west. Max melee sides. Max melee sides. Here's a bleed. Party's gonna be positioned east, tank's positioned west. We're going to be looking for the safe side. Alright. First up, white safe. Party, look for the white safe side.
And the white orb.
Go south. Party south. That was positioned on the wrong side. Yeah, there's a lot going on, but at least we got to it. Those towers, and then it's tanks and tethers, and then solve towers, and then after towers, it's immediately get into position for shadow clones. Okay, so now we can officially talk about Letter of Law. So, to start off all the mechanics, the party will be separated and the tanks will be on the other side. One of the tanks will be tethered and someone in the party will be tethered. We don't care about the party tether. Well, whichever tank is not tethered will come back to the party. The boss will channel a color where the opposite is safe. The squares will spawn, and he will spawn four orbs in the cardinal positions. The party will be looking for the safe side for their side between the east and the south, while the tank will be looking for the safe side on their opposite side. Basically, we just always it's same positionings as the one squares. The party always being on the eastern side, really, while the tank always being like on the western. And our safe spots is determined by where the circle is. Pay very close attention to the lines on the ground, because you'll have to be specifically positioned to avoid the other squares that are going off, you know, on the bullshit. Now, as soon as the squares get resolved, the adds will then immediately jump to the party. The party can start moving then, or whatever, towards the tank, while the tank will also start moving towards the party. The tank has to come to the party, because the party cannot make it to the tank in time before everything goes off. After we get through the add tether jumping, and we get to the tank safe spot, four towers will then spawn that requires two people to soak them. They will either spawn cardinals or intercardinals, I believe. And...
I don't know if they can spawn cardinals. I've only ever seen intercardinals.
You've only ever seen intercardinals? Then, since it will be intercardinal towers, we will have to do them true north. Supports moving counterclockwise to their partner at the tower.
It will be true north, and it's going to be your normal spread spot partners.
Yep.
Yes. To then soak those towers. Immediately after the towers get off, go to your light party positions for the shadow clones. Because as soon as the towers are done, the shadow clone mechanic will be going off. Once we then resolve the shadow clone mechanic, Letter of Law is then complete.
After the orbs and the squares go off, the parties stay where you are, the tank runs center.
But as soon as the ad hits you, haul ass to the tank.
Yes. As soon as the ads jump, then you have to go.
Because it is it's a hell of a quick rapid fire. Alright. Do we have any questions? Yeah, I guess no.
Nope.
stays on for Ace, because it seems kind of inconvenient for you to type all the after you just explained it to us.
Meh. It could be a variety of reasons.
Cheryl, no! No!
One thing I don't like about your top, Brendan, is the back stitching.
What's wrong with it?
Very feminine.
Was it feminine?
I don't know, it looks like the back of a corsage. Or a corset.
It's a vest.
That's just what it looks like. I'm being honest with you. Don't want my feelings, I won't give them.
The suit looks fine.
You can't see.
Power is just hating.
So yeah, it's modded.
We're talking mare stuff.
Okay. K-Root stream. Mods. Old. That shit's controller busted.
Controller broke. Don't pull.
Not just die.
Bro. Good thing I'm. They called me Fast Hand Sean. Mm. That was my name in the voice locker room.
Oh nice god. One.
Partners. at Alpha. Clocks to partners. I didn't have a partner.
The sauce.
Go to Bravo. Besides max melee.
Perfect.
White safe. Clocks into partner. Party positions, check the orbs, check the AoEs. Position now.
Wait, I thought we were in the orbs.
Dude, it spawned right on the left party positions. True north blocks to left parties.
Go out via the enemy.
Oof. Sadly, we came back in time.
Everyone out, purple line.
In, everyone out.
Like, if it's on your
so
light party
first,
position, you just stay there.
First start standing east and west, right? Like our Shadow Core positions as light parties. And then we watch where the AoEs spawn. If they spawn on top of us, then we just look at where the pink line is going, and we just move to the other side. If they don't spawn on top of us, aka they spawn north and south,
go to the north
your
one.
Light party will look at the north one and look where that one's going, and then move opposite of it.
Basically just east or north, that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
But that's not really true.
It is. The AoEs will only ever spawn east and west, or north and south. They will never crisscross applesauce or any of that.
I know that, but you guys were north at the time.
We weren't, we were west.
I was east and west.
Yeah, you ran all the way to our light party.
Because it was north. So in my brain, how I'm thinking about it is, you're saying we move north and west. I'm thinking if north is the safe zone, then we would follow that line. And if east was the safe zone, then we would follow that line. But that's not what you're saying.
Yeah, that's not what I'm saying.
It's the opposite.
If we're in light parties, like right now we're standing in a light party. If the orb, bam, spawns right here on top of us, and the line is heading this way, you just position on this side of the AoE, and then you'll follow around it. But if we're standing here, and we'll say the orb, that alpha, will be north, and, you know, it's coming this way towards us, if we're checking the north AoE, we then move downwards and position ourselves besides the southern one.
I don't know. I feel like my mind is seeing a simpler way of handling it, but I'm gonna try to do it the way you want to do it. I don't know. I feel like you're making it much more complicated than it needs to be.
I mean, I don't think so.
I know how I think about it, and I don't know how to describe it.
That's
more.
Wait. So,
okay.
From what you just said,
is this how PF does it too?
I mean, I don't know how PF does the AoE ones because, as far as I'm aware of, I mean.
So it's going counterclockwise. The orbs swap counterclockwise. You're saying your party goes over here, sheep?
Yes. If we are your guys' light party,
that
aka the ones who
so
all you
weird.
Do all we do is that we just move over to the other AoE and just hug it.
Hold on.
Yo, yeah. I'm about to fucking pull everybody into the goddamn simulator.
I'm just saying, you guys are moving so much farther than you should be. Let's say if it's counterclockwise, right?
I'm not moving hardly at all. I don't know how the fuck you guys are moving.
Yeah, what Cheap was trying to say is that if it's going counterclockwise, like from A going this way, you guys have to run all the way over here.
No, I just moved to the north side of the AoE and followed around.
Yeah, that's what I would think you guys would do, but what Cheap was trying to say is that you guys all go all the way around for it, rather than just doing simple sidestep.
So what you're saying, Ashian, is that there's no need to pre-position next to the other AoE, you just watch where the AoE is going, and then you just move.
Go, yeah.
See, that's what I thought, and then you're just like counterclockwise, clockwise, all this shit, and I'm just like, what the fuck?
I'm not saying counterclockwise, clockwise, anything. I've never said, never once did I say counterclockwise or clockwise while explaining that mechanic.
Yes, you did!
No, I did not. I said,
you have to just follow where the pink
your
is.
AoE spawns and where it's going to go.
I think
and then to pre-position yourself away from where it's going. So like I
follow
was saying, if, yes, so yeah. If your AoE you're looking at is alpha, and it's coming towards you, a la the one marker, then you just pre-position
behind
along the other AoE, aka its backside.
Position against the southern AoE.
Yeah.
If it's at north and moving clockwise, you would position along the southern AoE.
Yeah.
Because that would be the furthest that AoE would reach. The northern AoE.
So Ashian had done the mechanic wrong that one time, but he lived because there is enough room to have everybody on one side. I'm
there
not saying. But we're not doing that. But I just feel like it's so much more. Like, I don't know. Whatever. I'm just gonna try to follow Zay or Kaeru because I don't understand what you're saying to me, and it's.
Figure out a way for yourself.
Can we do pull up paint?
Paint.
I just feel like the mechanic is a lot more. You guys are making it a lot more complicated than it needs to be.
I'm literally not. I'm just asking people to pre-position in one spot.
Yeah, because east and west. If your orb's north or east, go to that one. And then.
But if anything, if you guys want to do anything different, that's a weird noise. So is our Discord noise. But if anything, if you want to change up any of what sort, just do Ashian's idea of just reposition west and east, and just look at which orb is going to be coming at you, and just move away from its direction as soon as the orb starts.
Oh, right now, east and west. It goes this way, yeah.
No, we're not we're not doing no life paint.
Huh? Please, I need to visualize. I'm a visualized learner, and I'm sure half of you guys are also visualized learner. Let's get this.
Yeah,
I
want to
walk on this like 5 times.
We already talked about markers. We already talked enough about it. We already used markers. We already showed it off. You guys are the ones who are constantly keep saying clockwise, counterclockwise, all this stuff. I'm literally just saying there's a pink line that spawns at the AoE beyond the opposite side of it. That is all I am asking.
Yes, I get it. But when you explained it, it was so confusing for no goddamn reason, so I'm trying to clarify it. Can we do that?
We're LARP Party 1. We go to the orb on the east. If it spawns in the east, if it goes north, go north. But just get on the opposite side of where the line's going. That's it.
But we didn't go north at all. The past 2 times.
So over here, in this hate stream.
Yes.
It's going this way. So are you saying
Correct.
Group 2 has to be over here?
Wrong.
No.
Because that is where the AoE is going. I'm saying on the opposite side of where the line is. If the AoE spawns on you, you go there. Correct.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought.
And that's what I was trying to tell Lexi when she was saying that we ran north, is that no, the AoE spawned on us, and she ran to the other side of the thing.
Yeah, because in my mind, when you were describing it, so you see where that all north, because no matter where it rotates, like if I thought we were going to be all north. So party two, we would have moved where group one is moving. That's how I thought it was going to be. That's how I thought you described it. But we're not doing it that way.
No. How I was saying is, in figure one there, that's in case, this is how the AoEs, if they spawn on the light parties, you just scoot to the backside of the AoE, where it's like not going. But what I was saying for the north and south is here in figure two, where light party one would be looking at the southern orb and looking where it goes, while light party two looks at the northern one and looks where it goes, and then positions accordingly.
Good enough for me.
That made sense to me.
Sounds,
Fucking SpongeBob.
It's good for me. Doodle off.
It makes sense to me.
The way you guys were.
I don't. It's not truly north and east priority, then. That's what I'm trying to say, and that's what was tripping me up.
If figure two, they go the opposite direction, that doesn't seem right. Make another orb going, going the other way.
No. We need a figure three and four.
We don't need it. No.
Yes, in that case, group two
than it is.
Would, Yeah, group two would go there.
Yeah, group two would go there, and then group one would have gone there.
Why don't we just have people watch the Yuki Zuri video of that section again?
No.
Yeah, I said we could have just done the simulator so we could just stick that mechanic.
With the simulator, the simulator's a thing now?
When I say north and south, I'm talking about the AoE spawning. I'm not talking about the safe zone.
But that's how
we wasted a lot of time.
That's how
I heard north and...
I was doing it last night, too, and we never had any issues.
Like, I always heard that as that's where it's spawning at.
Right, and break. Good team building. Let's get this present. Sides. Faces us when he's doing it. White safe. Knockers into max melee. Clocks light party. Partners. everybody in by parties. Now the overdraw.
Fucking hit when that happens.
Prepare for tethers. Four. Be purple safe.
Oh,
I was trying to stay.
I read that wrong.
This is blocked until light parties, but people are gonna die again anyway.
I thought the end was the same color.
Nope.
Get your eyes checked. No, I'm kidding.
And look at the tether, there's arrows on it.
We turned up the EC actually real quick. Girl! Are you fucking insane? No wonder I'm fucking
chance
freezing.
Chance is very, very low.
She set it to 72.
And then is she even home right now?
No! She's over at Adrian, staying the night!
Oh, your roommate.
That was so expensive, Sean.
Wait, 72 is freezing?
Well,
I didn't say it's freezing, it's low.
Oh,
no, brother, I'm in Texas. It's fucking 100 over 100 degrees daily.
Oh, man.
70 is probably a godsend.
Exactly.
I wanna hear about the little shit.
I know it's rookie numbers, I ain't giving a shit. Dying.
Nice.
Yeah, with 69? Nice.
Mike thinks I like it too cold, he hates that I leave my car on.
My car has temperatures.
Yeah, you know you can adjust the temperature of your car?
My car does not have numbers. It has dials. Alright? Yeah,
well, mine has as heated seats, it has cooling seats.
Yeah, mine is not fun. The cooled seat is really different.
Clocks and two light parties. Safe. Knockers into max melees. Positions.
I'm gonna do that.
Check your ads. Max melee. Clocks into partner.
Oh no!
I don't know why, it's just out of the way.
Right, my party signs? Check your AOE.
You're the last person I expect to go flying across there.
Okay, so going south, because I went to the north orb.
Drew north clocks until I parties. Oh, I lived because I'm a fucking animal.
I did a lot of fighting.
Fucking uphill tethering, everyone out. I can't get them. I don't have swift cast.
Partners.
Partners.
Don't shoot us.
besides max melee.
No! Oh no! Okay.
You got it, you got it.
I thought I killed him for a second. Wait, is Khan not my key? It's not my thing. I'm so sorry, Khan.
You almost to our stack is bleed.
Focus, bleed.
I mean, it shouldn't have bleed on.
No.
I was over.
Next time I'm
I know too well how much the goofy can take over. I have to put a stamp on it now before it takes too hard. Letter law, parting to the east takes to the west. White save. White save.
Close.
I'm trying to. It's immediately after the block.
Yes, as soon as the squares shoot, start making your way to the party. And the party can technically go at the same time as well, but...
And we have to wait for the jump to go off. We can't join them in the middle. Otherwise, we're not going to have a safe spot. That's why as soon as the orb and everything explodes, the tank runs in the middle, the party just kind of chills.
And just because it lines up so beautifully, we'll go ahead and take our break here.
Okay.
Just out of curiosity, do we have experience there?
Yes. I'm learning the mechanics, so it's really hard for me to be, like, in the moment with that, but I will try.
Understandable. Does everyone take a deep breath?
I can't remember. I have to look it up.
Nobody's upset, jokes.
Yeah, no one's upset.
Well, we've been yelling at each other half the night.
And out of love.
You don't know anything.
Khan's fuming.
It's our love language.
Exactly. It's not yelling. We're passionate.
No, Khan's the only one that has the right to be mad. I thought I was saving him from himself. I was like, I got you, Khan. No, if we raise our voices, Jokester, it's not because of anger. It's just me and Sean have a very passionate talk.
Mommy and Daddy aren't fighting.
As I always say, trust me, you'll know when I'm actually upset.
Well, I can tell it in the tone of your voice when you're upset, yeah.
You haven't seen the worst of him.
You have not seen.
Yeah,
I can tell being frustrated.
Now I'm kind of wanting to see if I can push that number.
You've seen frustrated and frumpy. You have not seen legitimately angry. Sean.
Sounds like a goal to me.
No, it is not. I am come to peace. I have let go of the demons that have gotten me there.
But he.
You don't let go of them. You just live with them.
I do miss those demons. Yeah.
No, you don't need to play Tarkov.
Sean was bad in Tarkov era.
I gotta use the bathroom real quick.
Sean got so bad, I even told him, I was like, I'm not hanging out with you when you're playing Tarkov. It was the only game I could not be around him for. Oh, God. Those are awful days.
Yeah. I miss those days.
That's when I started dumb.
I just need to buy that new computer so I can just play Tarkov again. God.
You bought an Xbox instead.
I did.
I'd pry you out of Tarkov with Warhammer 2.
Nah, Warhammer didn't take me out of Tarkov. My computer took me out. It couldn't handle it anymore. Good old League of Legends. Thank God for my fucking the school offering a free repair day. Because I lovingly slapped a hole right into the wall. Be right back, her.
Okay.
Playtime on Steam this past weekend was spent on Baldur's Gate 3.
Baldur's Gate 3 is pretty good.
Yeah, that's all of Steam.
Everyone's really upset because I have my boyfriend running around the camp naked.
Asteria?
Yeah. He's not in our party, so I just took off all his clothes, so whenever we did cutscenes,
oh, how lewd.
Naked. Like, it's shaking his head.
I'm going for Shadowheart in my game.
Oh man, someone going for Shadowheart. Who would believe it? Poor Yankee gets no love.
Yo, she is my second choice.
Yankee.
First is the drow.
Fuck is Yankee.
That's what you call her.
Geese.
The Yankee?
Yeah.
Lazel?
Yes.
Yes.
Gross.
Yes.
Wow!
It's where it's the drow is where it's at.
Oh, I'm not gonna lie.
They lay eggs. I'm not into that shit.
Brendan, if we played D&D still and this game was around, I would have built all my characters off of this and just been like, okay, you need to put this on the sheet for me.
Yeah, pretty much. The character portraits they actually put in the game are pretty good too.
Guess how many times Lexi had to restart her campaign.
They were not my choices. I was happy every time it was everyone around me who was sad. But I'm I'm playing a tiefling, druid, and mine and Mike's campaign. And I'm playing a wood elf assassin rogue and with Mike and Kyle. And I'm the worst assassin rogue you'll ever see in your goddamn life. I can't roll to save my life. Like, there was one time where I had a sneak attack and I had an 88% chance.
You still
like,
fucked that
times.
Up?
I fucked it up every single Kyle was like, Lexi, he has fucking 4 health. Just fucking pull out your dagger or something. Kill
right, not enough dex.
What do you
not
mean?
Enough dex.
I have the next one.
Just be Scrimbo.
You can have.
Yeah, you gotta be like Scrimbo.
Scrimbo hit every punch. 10% somehow it hits. Literally carried that one fight.
Like, I'm so half tempted just to fucking throw my race out and just try something else because I cannot save my life. I can't assassinate anything. Like, even.
Sounds like a skill issue to me.
Like, I feel like I've mastered, like, the sneaking around and hiding in battle so I can always get a surprise attack, and I just miss. It's green! All my chances are green! I've never had below 70% chance of not hitting something, and I still miss.
Trimbo needs no green advantage.
Get back here, you big bean.
I like the movement of the controller in Baldur's Gate 3, but it's so hard to go through all the menus.
Action. If you have the money, I'd recommend the DualSense Edge. It's actually a really nice controller.
No, my controller works. It's just that when I alt-tab sometimes, it gets disconnected. While it says it's connected, and I'm just like, huh.
When you said it broke, I thought you meant it.
Yeah, I'm like, the fuck, did you grip it too hard or what?
thought you legitimately broken your controller.
Mm-hmm. No.
Did we wipe too many times and just threw your controller at the wall in rage?
I never understood people who do that. Especially since controllers nowadays are fucking
expensive as fuck.
Yeah. Hey, I didn't punch. I slapped. The wall was weak.
I never really did understand how people throw their controllers and shit. Like, that's a $60 fucking controller. You're really gonna break it in half. Yeah.
Been in call with Kyle before. I heard it hit the fucking wall, and then he muted. And he came back about an hour later, and he said, "I had to go to Best Buy. I bought a new
one." I remember when you told me about that.
Oh yeah.
My controller cost $200. This thing breaks.
Dude, what the fucking controllers cost $200?
PlayStation ones are pretty expensive.
Yeah, the Elite brand type bullshit.
You're just paying for the brand at that point.
PlayStation doesn't have many off-brand controllers, unfortunately.
The off-brand ones suck.
But they're significantly cheaper.
You're talking about controllers being expensive? I was reading a thing about a guy who got pissed off playing Street Fighter and threw his controller through this glass door to the backyard.
Regular controllers are only about $60. This one was just expensive because it's a pro controller.
It is. But I love the way PS5 controllers feel in my
hand. Alright. Yeah, do it with the fights. Yeah. Alright. Clear the mines. Re-up your food if you need to. Remember, we're going for that final hour. We're going for the push. Dance partner, por favor.
I think I used the wrong. Or wait, no, I didn't. Never mind. False alarm.
Dance partner.
Dance partner.
I am. I was jostling my buttons.
Alright.
That doesn't sound good.
Pepper voice.
Thanks, dance and dicks out, okay?
I see why not, we're all in our houses. I assume you're in your house. I feel like you'd be a little weird if you're up in someone else's debate.
I don't
want to
know if you're dicks or out.
Positions into lighty parties. Tether in, everybody out. Then you go to your partner. Melees. Knockers into max melees. I popped that so early. second Dom. My party's Fox. Check your ads. Clocks to partners. Distracted by Zeus to not be able to react. Hang on, give me a second.
I don't think there's any reaction to that. I think there was only.
No,
there was not notifications used there. Reprisal did not go off.
Yeah, I think that that AoE one shot me. So. Someone in Sargnava's network earlier said his range are useless. I was like, what?
I mean, sure, DPS-wise, they're not the best, but they do offer a lot of support that comes in handy.
I fucking hate when Zeus does that.
What did he do?
He'll just suddenly get interested in the front door like someone's interacting with it.
What? Makes you think there's a ghost there or some shit?
No. Makes you think there's an actual person there fucking with my door. I'm gonna have to fucking shoot.
Haven't people said you have a ghost, though? I'm like,
yeah.
Just
yeah, yeah, like... Yeah. You always think the ghost is fucking with you or something.
Hang on, I'm on my computer. Now I'm back. And yes,
welcome back.
This house is definitely haunted. The proof is in the fact that alarm radio that I used, that I hadn't used for 2 years, suddenly came on one night.
Must have been really alarming.
Yep. The thing still sits there unplugged.
Sleeping in one day and suddenly you hear static.
Just white noise.
Heart nerves.
Yeah.
Howdy.
Yeah, they're in. Everyone out. No partners. Sides to partners. Box until light parties. Bravo.
Shit fucking hurt.
In, Haru.
Then light parties.
Light parties.
I need to start using something.
No, I need to stop using my bubble for sticks. Kind of,
little goof ups.
Well, this is a wide turn.
Yeah, we don't have enough people for tethers.
Oop.
I'm Haru at C, and then need a one.
I'm E. What do you mean? I'm supposed to tether.
Hmm? Aren't you long tether?
No.
Oh, whoop. Then I misread that. My bad.
I usually have my bubble there for that bleed, but sometimes off of muscle memory I pop it for sticks, but it's the one sticks I don't need to pop it for. So I just need to stop doing that. Life will be good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just stop it.
That's right.
Thank you. Welcome back, Zay. I am speed. Oh, it wore off.
I don't know why that's working.
Knockers, max melee.
If I stand here, Zay's arcane circle will help me.
Four. Max melees.
partner!
Oh no!
Oh, I was on the wrong. Yeah.
I didn't die. Check tethers.
White.
White. White! Clocks into partners. Let's play it safe. Hang in there. My party positions. Watch the AoEs.
Probably need to be in this spot.
Yeah, but who cares?
As long as you're spaced out.
True north. Blocks true north. Clocks until my parties. Sides. To the east, tanks to the west. White safe.
I underestimate how large that AoE is.
Side of, like, the boss's hitbox, right, Ashian?
Huh?
Like, you're basically hugging the boss's hitbox for waiting for the ad to jump to you.
In the boss jumps.
The thing could go silent.
Yeah. I have to go, like, that sound.
Oh, yeah. That's my fault.
Whoever had the tether at the heart of the thing.
That was me.
So, when the orb is here, if this is gonna be like the safe spot, you can make sure.
Yeah. You have to.
If you go
too far,
you
literally. I mean, maybe, but then the issue comes down to that, what you call it? The AoEs being overlapped from the ads. But alright. Let's go ahead and continue hitting her head.
I highly tell you it's not. Being hit by it is what applies to you.
Come on, we're at 20%.
There's
if we
some.
Get through that, we can kill it.
Yeah, law is the very final mechanic.
Yeah. Law's letters, well, yeah, the very last one. Partners. By Haru. Oh, nice.
Nice.
I put out a little there.
I come to three. Max melees. No, I popped that so
Ooh.
Hard. It'll be fine.
It's gonna hurt.
The friends you're looking for is gonna take it. Tether in everyone now. The partners. Too close. Oricron, no back.
I don't know if we've got enough time. Just had to have faith.
Check tethers. Purple. My parties. Check AoEs. Turn north clocks. Until light parties. Clocks until light party. Everybody inside, then light party. Science into partners. Letter. Purple. wait. Tank. Take the towers. Oh, Lexi died. And then after the towers, you would have to run to your to my party at spots. Yeah.
I'm at the tower. My tower on the four.
No, you would have. Yeah, you would have been at the tower at four, Jokester.
It is.
Yeah,
his partner stacks from the first clock.
Yes. So you'll always be with Khan either at four or alpha.
Okay.
There's a knockback after the Shadow Messengers go across.
Yeah, another dismiss to use knockback immunity.
Yeah, there is a very sneaky little knockback there. You'll see it when the boss is casting dismissal. And then when you're running to the tank, you're actually going to be running to where the ad is like standing or wherever. So don't get too caught up on positioning on top of the tank. When you look for the ad that jumped to them.
Ignore tank. Run to ad.
And if you need to stop casting, then please stop casting. There's a lot of running around that's going to be happening in that. Program opening for my computer that I think I accidentally opened.
Nah, it was the ghost fucking with it.
Clocks to partners.
I'm not that good.
Ghost isn't allowed to be 3D modeling while I'm reading.
Hiya.
Yeah. I think I'm Blender. Can we work together?
It's
gonna take longer to open because I don't have a working license for it.
What, you know what I'm trying?
Sides and two partners. No, I'm not paying for fucking bio. That shit's like $200 a year or whatever. I'd do that if I could just. Why would I do that if I could just use Blender, which is free?
Or
my hand has nice shaders.
Purple. Knockers, max melee. I'd be willing to like have a torrent of Maya, but at the same time, like I said, why would I do that if I could just have Blender, which is free?
Though it also occurred to me, Harry is playing the copper deck, so...
Yeah?
Careful with it. Well, don't say things you fired it.
Eh, a small time. Okay. No one watches.
So, yeah. Check your ads. Focus up with this one. Watch on Jester. Max melees. Max melee, max melee, max melee, max melee.
Okay. Nice.
Clocks into my parties.
3.
Signs to partners. To partners. Max melee sides. Parties? Check AoEs. True North clocks to light parties. Inside to light party.
No sides.
Sometimes upheaval and dismissal confuse me.
Oh, good. We know what you meant.
Sides, partners.
Thanks for the follow, Mochi.
Stop knockering.
hard at all. Die. Finder spots.
I'm on the wrong one.
Oh!
Yeah, we did get to our life part spots. I thought that tower was gonna hurt.
Yeah, I thought it was going to kill us all, but apparently we could miss one person in the tower.
Yeah, we could have recovered from that and, like, LB'd or something afterwards, but I thought we were dead from the tower.
Yeah.
That's what I thought,
so
too.
So now we know, if one person is dead, we can definitely survive towers.
Yeah.
And then, it will definitely kill
us eventually,
but at least we can practice running for our lives to our light party spots.
Yeah. We'll at least see Enrage, but we can practice mechanics and all that.
But yes, as soon as towers are resolved, you need to haul ass to your light party spots for the clones.
Keep track of where True North is, because we're either always going to be east or
west. Well, actually... I just realized something. Wait, what was that you said, Brendan?
You just gotta keep track of where True North is.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, it's Alpha Marker.
Yeah. Look at A.
Yeah,
but,
you know where your partner's thoughts
are. Is that for... Is that 3 for 3, the tower spawn and Cardinal?
3 and... Yeah, it is.
Alright, so I think the towers... I'm not sure if it's 50-50. Huh?
I think it's always been harder than your target. Because I've gone to the 3 marker.
Yeah, I've gone
to
the... I've gone to
the,
like,
one-ish. Okay, then never mind. That just throws away what I was going to say. Well, kind of, sort of, not really, but... Because I was just thinking about with the safe spots for the adds, instead of having to haul ass to our positions. Technically, all these spots here are the safe spots for the clone adds, no matter what. So if you don't feel confident making it to your east and west default spots, you can go to the triangles here, north and south, and you should be fine, because ads only ever spawn intercardinals. True. Well, I mean...
Yeah, we have, like, time for one more pull, right?
Yeah, I mean, one more good pull.
One more good one.
But, I guess. The ads are always going to shoot in any direction, so you should always be able to move into the purple ad. To see how it plays out. This is just me and Lucky theorizing into the void.
Khan's down too.
Max melee sides.
Is
white.
Right.
Knockers. The partners.
Oh,
Hey, we're speaking again.
Into my park. Locks into partners.
That AoE looked a little too close.
Sides into partners. Buff me, Brennan got. Hey, good job. Light party spots, check your things. Dexter, stop. And then light parties. Partners.
rumble.
Good night, Haru.
Psycho. Good night. BSCon. Let's see. Yeah, the tower spawned there at 3, so that was the inner cardinals. So for you, Con, you would have been at 4. It's all good. Like I said, there's a lot of fireworks and chaos going off there, so it just takes mechanical practice. I mean, we got it down. Well, that's good. We at least got to letter of law.
Progress.
Okay, do homework if you need to. Or any of that horseshit for Saturday.
We could potentially clear that Saturday.
We push for the clear on Saturday. Letter of Law is the very final mechanic, and then it just repeats into Enrage.
I think that kind of nailed it there.
We just need to stop getting clipped by things here and there and all that, and for Gucci. Yeah.
And react faster to Letter of the Law, but then that just gotta practice it.
That's all it is fast.
So how
everything
was that?
We know how to do.
Oh, he's already gone. I saw Ashton testing out his theory about this hollow grounding there.
In the middle.
Yeah.
Probably just gave him damage down, didn't that?
Eh. But otherwise.
Or anyway, so.
Otherwise, that's it for tonight, sillies. Do homework if you need to. Ask questions if you got any. And we push for the clear Saturday. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
How do you find happiness?
You must find it within yourself.
I looked inside myself and there's no happiness there.
You must make your happiness.
How do you make it?
I gotta get my happiness out of me with this knife I found.
No, cut it out now.
Right,
oh, is the seasonal event happening right now?
Yeah, it should have started today.
Gotta get the Power Rangers outfit.
Yeah. I gotta head back to Sargatavis.
Sarg.
Go back where you came from.
I will happily.
Alright, I'm gonna head out. You guys have a good night.
I don't want to stay on Crystal. Ugh.
Alright. I'm just gonna keep the stream going just for a little bit longer before I end it. I definitely do want to get that Power Rangers outfit. And then, just gotta figure out where it is. Just chill out in my Discord for a bit. Where the fuck is it? Is that it? No. Probably upper decks. Don't give a shit about your dialogue. Just give me the Power Rangers outfit. Where do I gotta go? That's not it. Gotta have Harambe lifting me up, always. Where's the NPC? Too many people here. Okay, there's not me. In a cutscene, so they can't even see me. It's like he's bending over ready to get dick down. Anything interesting happening for the cutscene? Oh, what the? Say, give me that outfit. You don't deserve it. Give it to me. Oh, there it is. After this quest, I get it. What am I supposed to do here? I vaguely remember them. Don't know who they are. Like every seasonal event, those two are there. He'll learn more to lift himself up. Yeah, show him how it's done. Damn, listens to words of encouragement from a random stranger over his own sister. What a dick. Get shot. Oh, thank you for the follow, Extreme Insanity. I love the name. I think I probably ruined a attempted romance right there, but oh well. Wait, there's more? Oh. My raid group. Extreme Insanity. I'm gonna guess between Ashian, Khan, or maybe Zay. One of you guys, the insane ones. Huh. That leaves Obek. Or maybe Jokester. Jokester, sup, Jokester. What are you up to now that we're done for tonight? The fuck is he doing? That's not even squats anymore, this is gyrating. Look at all those muscles, they'll be fine. Godbert, yeah. They're trying to become Godbert themselves. What do you mean, under the sun? It's nighttime. No matter what, it's the same dialogue. It doesn't even matter if it's like fucking raining, if it's stormy outside, they'll just say whatever they want to say. Like, just nothing but thunderstorms outside. What a lovely day outside. I'm choosing all the wrong dialogue choices in here. Heh. Someone fell off the course. They'll be fine. Shh. Both of them, the same thing, just said differently. True, sometimes it's more fun, but I think I fucked up the potential romance one with the two pirates. I kinda wanted to see what would have happened if I chose the right option. Yeah, a lot of the times I wait till the very last minute to do it, but since I was online and figured, eh, why not? I'm already logged in. Why wait till the next time I'm logged in? But I'm probably not going to log in until Saturday. So I'm like, eh, might as well do it right now. Yeah, if you already do it now, it's gonna be crowded as fuck. There's a lot of people in here, so the things are gonna load up a little slower. Yeah, the jump puzzle, it's interesting, but I just completely forgot all about it, to be honest. I don't think the jump puzzle is the focus at this, for this seasonal event anyways. The focus right now is on the whole choosing dialogues and talking to people. But I'll attempt the jump puzzle, just cause. I've had enough of your shenanigans, doing my Power Rangers outfit. What? That's a weird jump. Talking to shark on the beach. Oh, that's what happens when I skip cutscenes. Wait, isn't this the kid who's got her parents got eaten by bears? Now she's gonna get damn. They're everywhere now. Then he gets eaten. He's literally jumping right into its fucking jaw. And the shark chooses to punch, as opposed to bite. Literally within biting distance. Give him a mask so he feels the placebo effect of the boost from the outfit. I don't know what to fucking say. Let's go with the first one. Real life would be like, woo, you got this. The cheese. Yep, he's the sunshine savior. The fucking Power Rangers explosion. Yep, safe, long load times. Okay, there we go. Give me my outfit. There we go, seasonal event complete. Now I can try on. Now I'm a Power Ranger. Wait a minute. My fucking tail is gone. The outfit get it cuts off your tail! It is a pretty fucking badass outfit. I like it. Now let's attempt the jump puzzle. See how bad we are at this shit. Yeah, when it comes to the Hildebrand quests, I mean, I loved doing them. The ARR ones were the best, in my opinion. Heaven Sword, alright. Stormblood, okay. But now I just am like, I'm in no rush to do it. Plus, like, I know a lot of people are doing it just for the sake of the fucking relic weapons right now. I don't really care about getting the relics, as opposed, considering I've never ever finished a single relic weapon I've started. But I'll get around to doing the Hildebrand quests because they're funny. They're good. Okay, jump puzzle right here. Nope. I fucked it up. Yeah, I'll... I figured, with Hildebrand quests, it's nothing but just goofy antics. It's like Toon Force in Final Fantasy. I'll get to it, though. Son of a bitch! How do I fuck up that one? It's like I can just pick up where I left off, but it's not the same unless I do it all in one sitting. Son of a fucking bitch. I'm trying to go fast with it, but I think I'm gonna have to take my time if I actually want to clear it. But the point is, do it fast if you want to be to brag about it. If anyone can do it slower, take the easy way. I've attempted Kukatani Tower. I got far into it, but I've never climbed to the top of it. Hey, they got the fucking polar bears here. I'm set them on fire. Okay, this is my checkpoint. I'm not starting all the way the fuck over. Okay, let me try climbing. Like climbing. But yeah, Kukatani Tower, I don't know if I'll ever complete it. No. No, fuck! I jumped too far. Jump puzzles. Oh. Okay, don't jump here. Ah, this is where the pain. I fucking hate those curves. Fuck! Alright. Remember, just talk to them. Yeah. Now I don't have to jump up there or run up the ramp. There we go. Alright, let's... Fuck! They're like sprint or something. Yeah, for Kukatani Tower, I don't think I have the patience to do it either, because it's a lot of this. It's a lot of fucking pain. And frustration. It's like, at least with these courses for the seasonal events, you have checkpoints. You can just... But if you make, like, almost damn near top of Kukatani Tower, and you fall down, you're gonna fucking want to shoot your brains out. Son of a bitch! I'm too scared to fucking... No! God damn it. I fucking hate jump puzzles. I still haven't quite figured out the sweet spot to get it consistently. For a second I said STD. Oh no! I screwed myself over because I didn't believe. Make a drinking game out of this. Every time you fall down, take a shot. Son of a bitch. That's the point, Jokester. That's the point. Falling so many times, I'd be dying of alcohol poisoning at this point. Like that. Oh, there's my friend Nami. Yay! Oh. Shit. Well, at least I don't have to start all the way the fuck over. That'd be annoying. No! Fuck me. There is no checkpoint. This is the closest checkpoint. I have to do that bullshit from the side. Even my palms are getting sweaty, goddamn. Ah, you'll be fucking kidding me. I appreciate it, Jokester. I'll see you on Saturday. Good luck to us all getting that clear on Saturday. Have a good night. Close to wanting to give up, but I know I'm close. I know I am. Come on. feel like this is like way more intense than a boss fight right now, because fuck. Okay. Are you fucking kidding me? That's the part I mess up on. I know I get nothing out of this, just personal gratification. But fuck, if I'm not gonna clear it, or complete it. Fuck it. I'm calling it for now. I'm not gonna give up on it forever. The event's still lasting for another 2 weeks or something. I'll attempt it, but right now it's getting me fucking tilted. I need to get to bed in, like, preferably within 20 minutes since I have to work at 8 a.m. I still have to walk this one and make sure everyone's got enough food and water last night and all that good shit, so I'm gonna call it here before I lose my fucking mind. So, for anyone still watching, as always, I appreciate you guys. Hope to see you next time on Saturday when I hopefully get the clear in P11S. That way we can finally step foot into P12S, the last boss of the fucking tier. And then I can say I'm done. I'm taking a break from Savage raiding because the shit's exhausting. I like it. It's fun. But it is aggravating at times, and sometimes I just want to just not have to worry about a set schedule, raiding consistently, and just take a break and relax. But yeah, I'll wait till after this tier is over to do that. So, as always, thank you. Hope to see you next time. Y'all have a good night.